What's up, everybody? Y'all like my shirt, Highway to Hell? I am getting ready to start a Zoom meeting. It's a new book that I got from the library. And then I'm actually doing my hair. So I'm gonna tell you guys why I'm doing my hair. Why you can spot a real one from a fake one in terms of returning citizens. And I know that a lot of companies, if you've ever watched that movie, Crash, they hire returning citizens. Not a bad thing. But one of the things that I always tell people, how come you can't keep your fucking mouth shut? And the reason why I say that is because I know a real one from a fake one. What a lot of people don't realize, this guy told me immediately, he knew me from Baltimore. Who the fuck you don't? I haven't lived in Baltimore in many, many years. Talking about he knows people. Let me make it clear for the last final fucking time. I am not from Baltimore. I'm not from New York or any of these places that I've worked in. My ancestors, because I'm Native American, but this guy's never seen me a day in his dope-selling life. Allegedly, he sold dope. Let me get my brush real quick. Houston, we got a problem. I'll be right back. I gotta find that problem. This is all the stuff I gotta take to go donate. See this nice chair? I'm clipping my ends and doing my hair. I'm not sitting in that. I won't mess with my furniture. Alrighty, this is Juicy Couture, by the way, in case you really want to know. So, what I am saying is that you need to be careful just bragging about things. You don't know who you're talking to. And, you know, one of the things that I know very quick is when somebody is jealous as fuck. You know, when they start trying to compare their life and what they have to what you have. Now, keep in mind, this is a repair person. How come I knew more about doing the install than he did? You know, the way that this condo is set up, you have multiple providers in which you can choose from. And so I had already had everything set up so that way when I moved, it could be done. Now the rep was like, do the self-install. And I'm like, okay, for the internet, that's fine. Even for the cable and all that other stuff, not a problem for me. When I get here, everything, whoever set up the electricity, we got an issue because I keep seeing sparks coming out of the outlets and I keep seeing some of the outlets don't work. So one of the things that I make known to people is that education is a powerful thing. Let me show you the book. I was in a pre-apprentice program to be an electrician. Here's the book. It was with phase three. Unfortunately, phase three did not have their stuff together. We didn't get the book. We didn't get computers. We didn't have a syllabus until weeks into the course. They were supposed to provide $1,000 stipend, which is a great, you know, incentive. So a lot of these workforce programs that I tell people are scamming, they are. So I know a lot about electricity because I've studied it a long time ago. That's why I got the book. I don't need them to scam me. I asked them for my stipend. They wanted me to sign paperwork. Why would I sign paperwork if you have not done what you were supposed to do with the course? And I'm asking to resume the course at a later date, the next cohort. Too much like correct. And your own people want to do the scamming to you. So with this individual, right? Automatically is a red flag when he's coming in here saying that he knows me from Baltimore. No, the fuck you do not. But do you know who I know from Baltimore? A lot of corrupt officials, a lot of dope-smoking, junkie crackhead bums who like to stalk and harass people. I know, because they wanted to follow me around. Absolutely was not having it. So not only he'd tell me where he used to live and all this stuff. He was trying to convince me that he had actually gotten charged as a juvenile to 21. I said, whoa, stop right there. First of all, do you realize what you're saying? How are you being charged as a juvenile to 21? Doesn't make sense. What did you do? What did you really do? And then that's when he admitted it, that yeah, he had gotten caught up in some stuff, XYZ, and that he continued to sell drugs. Okay, here's the thing. We all know that a lot of times in communities, these drugs are pushed off into our community by the government. However, do not fall for the trap of thinking that free, easy money is going to be what you want. It's not. Criminal justice system is human trafficking. And so they're waiting on you, counting on you, hoping that you will take the bait. When I mean take the bait, that you will think this is the only opportunity that I have. And that's why they glamorize drug culture in prisons, because they're all operated by BlackRock, Vanguard, all these things. So not only is this guy very intelligent, he's also coming with some covert information. So first thing I do is find out all your information. See, people, and you, because the way I was dressed yesterday, I had on my leather, my suede and all. Y'all see the coat, right? So people automatically assume that I am doing all these illegal activities, right? Good, I hope you think that. Because I want to know, what the fuck are you coming up in here talking about? You know me from a certain place. Who sent you? Who hired you? So a lot of these contractors, which he is, he's bragging, oh yeah, I make $110,000 and I got a huge house out Hagerstown. And guess what he also told me? He sells weed to the police, which wouldn't be an issue. I mean, who hasn't, right? But fuck you telling me for? You don't know me. You must not know I live under FBI surveillance, so they're gonna fucking know about this shit. Rule number one, you keep your fucking mouth shut. If you're doing all these things, you shouldn't be telling these things. And then here's the kicker he doesn't get. He thinks he's selling weed to the police. No, you're not. You're selling weed to an undercover, stupid. And what a lot of times they do, the police, the prosecutors and these people, they hold these cards on you, like the Illuminati card game. So when they need something or they feel that they own you, they'll come to collect. Haven't seen that movie with the FBI? Judas and the Black Messiah? True fucking story. True fucking story. And so when he's so willing to brag about that, he's thinking he's protected. I had to break it down, sweetheart. You ain't got more protection than me. You never served in the military. Uh-huh. You never worked in the United States government. You never worked in law enforcement. So they're telling you that they're going to protect you and that they're going to help you get this job and turn your life around. And, you know, he even told me he just calls the sheriff if he needs something. I'm glad to know. So I just want to send a special shout out East Baltimore and Hagerstown and Clarksburg and all that, your sheriffs and all that. Y'all little snitch bitches is out here running their fucking mouth. So now I have to come and investigate you all. Because when somebody is that bold and that brazen, and he's, you know, trying to, you know, why you only have a condo? You could get a three-bedroom. Sweetheart, multiple properties. One thing you should never do is assume anything about anyone. And, you know, he doesn't realize, yeah, he makes $110,000 a year. He's owned for that $100,000, and then he's going through all this shit at his job. And I'm trying to break it down to him. You know, he act like he has all this power, and I'm like, sweetheart, people that really have power don't have to go around bragging about it. Same thing with money. I only talk about my financial success because it's attributed to the Lord. It's attributed to my hard work. It's attributed to education and taking the opportunity to turn my life around as a returning citizen when I was a teenager, you see, not an adult. But unfortunately, people just don't want to let you move past your past. And my past is not for everyone to know. I just make it clear. I was never a prostitute, never a drug user. I was never a sex offender. I was never a thief. I never did robbery or any of these things. What the fuck for? I'm the one catching y'all stealing out of my house, out of my safe houses. Exactly. Make it make sense. And then he's bragging about who he's selling to. So you don't think at some point, if something were to go down, they wouldn't cut him loose and throw his ass on the goddamn street so fast? They will take everything that he has, you know, and trying to, you know, explain to him that, you know, he was talking about he had to get custody from the wife of his children. Now, make this make sense. He's telling me that his first child he had only because the woman was a dyke. And so she wanted a baby. So you went and procreated with someone, not knowing anything really hardly about them. They just wanted a baby. So this tells me you really ain't got it all together in your head. And I had to break it down that spiritually, when you sleep with someone, you're sleeping with their spirits. Yes, a lot of them have a lot of spirits. And so, okay. That's your life. That's what you want to do. You want to go out here spreading your seed to make babies with a woman. Okay. So now he has that child. Then he talked about the second child. You know, she tried to get him locked up. I already knew stuff, and I was already telling him these things before he told me. And that's why he fucking told me these things. And I'm not displaying his thing. I'm not giving his name or anything like that. But I'm just, you know, trying to say that you need to make better choices in life. And don't be running your mouth to people you don't fucking know. You know, I explained to him that, like, you might feel comfortable telling me stuff. Who else are you running your mouth to? Because you want to get the people that's allegedly helping you, protecting you in trouble. Not like that, but clearly, I know your ass is not to be trusted, and you came up in here with an agenda. Yeah, you don't, I hardly let people come to my house anymore. You know why? Because they're nosy, they're liars. Oh my God, I just want to see how the fuck I live. So I make videos and show y'all. And I'm going to show y'all something that is going to shock you. See how I'm cleaning my brush? And I have real hair scissors, real shears. Get professional grade supplies. My flat iron, ceramic, is only like $64. But works really well. I have naturally curly hair, a lot of hair. Gets the job done. So I had already, yes, let me tell you a secret that we women, especially black women, that we do. Not even a secret, but sometimes we don't have the whole head done. So we have to improvise. So yesterday, no one was none the wiser that none of this, I didn't blow dry it or anything. So yeah, I got a lot going on. But one of the things I pay attention to is people when they talk, and they talk too fucking much. See, people think I talk too much. No, I make you feel comfortable, stupid. That's what a real prosecutor is supposed to do. That's what a real police officer, a real detective, real everything, real lawyer. I'm going to get ready to be. It's supposed to do. Get you in your element. Get you out of your element. Tell me everything I need you to tell me. And you will. You just have no idea. I don't have to put spells on you. And people talk about these cartel members are putting spells so they don't get arrested. No. They're just distracting you and trying to do a whole bunch of hocus pocus bullshit. So, back to this individual. So, I had already told him. I said, you know, you got to be careful. Be more careful. That's what people say they're from Baltimore, about who you choose to have children with. Because you don't know. Your little baby mama is getting paid to come after you. Getting paid for all this stuff, you know. And it won't be the end of it. Because he's still paying for child support. And I told him that child support is a system in which the states want to tear apart the family. Right? But on the other hand, it's a system that's supposed to be designed to hold the absentee parent accountable, right? You can't just go around making babies. And that goes for women, too. You can't go around having babies by multiple men. She's looking for that big payday. I told him, gave him some good advice. You need to get a lawyer. You need to get an accountant. And you need to have, wherever you're paying child support, give an account. Why are they garnishing you? Because they will garnish you. They can take your fucking house, and that's what he doesn't realize. You know, they can make that bill get into the arrears so much, before you know it, your little three-bedroom house is gone. I had to explain, condo building I live in is brand fucking new, custom built. So, run, tell your mouth about that. And don't compare yourself to others. I don't expect people to have what I have. I don't want to have what you have. I want to have what I want to have. But don't get it twisted, thinking that because you make a certain amount, you live a certain place, that you can't get touched. You can. And when I mean touched, I don't mean physically touched. I mean the government, the police, whomever, that you have sold.